How do you review a game that has unlimited games in it? Dreams is a PlayStation 4 exclusive brought to you by Media Molecule, the same people that made the Little Big Planet series, and of course Tearaway as well. This is my first review of a 2020 game. I'm incredibly, incredibly excited about 2020. I think it's going to be an amazing year for video games. And it starts off with Dreams, the first kind of major release of this kind of 2020 era. And you know what? I think, in all honesty, this is already a Game of the Year contender. Dreams, in case you haven't heard of it before, it's essentially the next step for what Little Big Planet was trying to do. With Little Big Planet, you could create platformers and share them around the world. Mostly platformers. People found ways of doing like other things. Like, I think there was a first-person demo that someone tried to make, and there was also like a Mirror's Edge clone that someone made. But nonetheless, it was very tailor-made to be a platform maker, where you could create a platform or create levels that look like platformers with Sackboy running around. And they made three of those, and they all had different things going for it, and they try to add more with each entry into the series. But essentially, it was a platform maker, sort of what like Super Mario Maker is today. When I first saw what Media Molecule were trying to do with Dreams about 2 years ago, I think is the first time I saw it, I was immediately taken back by how they said, you literally can create full-on 3D games from the comfort of your own home. And I immediately thought, well, it's going to be quite limited. I don't think you're actually going to be able to create fully-fledged 3D games, like proper video games in a video game. There's probably going to be some limitations to what you can do through animations, maybe even textures or something. There's got to be something. I didn't believe it for a second. And I was lucky enough to get an early copy of this game, and for the past week, I've been playing it nearly every single day. Dreams is incredible. It is absolutely incredible. The potential, and this is the main thing with this game, and it's really hard to rate it because it's not really a game. There is a single player mode in this that lasts for a few hours, and it kind of showcases off kind of everything you can do in Dreams, kind of like what they did with Little Big Planet, where they would showcase different mechanics you could use for, and then when you finish the single player, you could learn from those mechanics into creating your own levels and sharing them with other people and stuff like that. Sort of in the similar vein, the single player is just loads of production. Obviously, they've taken a lot of time to do the single player up because they want to show the best of everything Dreams can be. And it's a really, really good showcase. But the main chunk of Dreams is playing levels that other people have played and have shared online for you to dive into. And the possibilities are absolutely fucking endless with this game. I'm so blown away by some of the creations I've played. And remember, this game just got released today, Valentine's Day, if this video goes out on Valentine's Day. The game just got released today. The possibilities, once this goes out into the public and everyone's kind of creations come to life and people have ideas they want to do, and the full release comes out, basically out of beta, I'm just so excited for what's to come with this game. I really enjoyed playing Little Big Planet, but after the second one, I got a bit bored of it because it was kind of the same old thing. It was just the same playing through platform levels. It got boring a little bit quick. Dreams is trying to counter that by having just a complete engine for you to work in. To go into detail of what you can do in Dreams, it is really endless. You can voice act in this game. You can create giant open worlds in this game with just incredible detail. You can create the most realistic looking scenes you can possibly think of in engine on your couch using a PlayStation 4 controller. You can do any type of genre you can possibly think of and maybe create an even new one yourself in Dreams. You can do animations for characters. You can do actions for different button presses, and when certain things happen in the game or certain levels, you can apply visual effects, and you can do all sorts. You can create music for this game and then share that with other people, the tracks, and share them with other people so they can use them in their game. It's fucking bonkers. This is an absolute 100% must play just from the potential of what this game can do. It is a real-time engine that allows anyone to create any game they can think of from the comfort of their own couch. That, to me, is mind-boggling. There's no coding. There's nothing like that. As long as you have a vision and you have some sort of idea of what you want to do and have a basic understanding of logic, really, just how video games kind of work and, you know, collisions and all that kind of stuff, then you're not going to struggle with this. In fact, you're going to have an absolute time of your life trying to create your own video games from scratch. It is long, but that's part of the process of Dreams. Dreams, you will have to go through tutorials to learn pretty much everything. But once that's over and done with, it's an open world. It's literally an open canvas for you to decide what you want to do. And Dreams allows people to do this. This is the easiest version or tool I've seen that allows you to create games from scratch. It's mind-blowing. I can't believe this is a thing, and we've got to this stage in 2020 where I can create video games from the comfort of my own couch using the PlayStation 4 controller. It's bonkers. It can get overwhelming at times, but that really is down to how you view Dreams. You know, if you feel like Dreams is a hard thing to, you know, create a game for, then you're going to realize that Dreams, if you look at every other way of creating a video game, you'll realize that Dreams is actually one of the easiest way of just creating a thing, a level, a design, or even a game itself. That part, to me personally, because I understand how video games are made and I know how hard it is to actually get one of these off the ground, to play Dreams was an absolute refresher, because it was just sitting down and going, right, what do I want to make? Okay, I'm going to make a racing game. And then I just start making a racing game. Dreams to me right now doesn't feel like a video game. It feels like something I boot up when I have an idea and I want to create something, or I just want to add something to an existing game that I'm currently making at the moment. And to me, it's a different way of spending time with video games where you're actually feeling creative and you're feeling productive. And to me, for someone who tries to be productive at least 70% of the time, most of the day, Dreams made me feel great. Normally, if I play a video game and I play it for a long time, sometimes I can start to feel like, oh God, I've spent like 6 hours playing this. But with Dreams, it had a weird effect on me where I was like, I spent 6 hours on this level and it looks great, but I still have loads to do. But you have that, you know, sense of achievement, sense of accomplishment that you don't get from anything else. Like, Dreams is truly unique, truly one of a kind, because it's a tool to create whatever the fuck you want in terms of a video game. And that, to me, just has potential written all over it for the year and years to come. Because I think Dreams, despite we're getting to the point where at the end of the PlayStation 4 cycle, Dreams is honestly one of the biggest games that has, I think it's one of the most important games that's come out on the PlayStation 4 in a long time, if ever. The weird thing is, and it's obviously to do with next gen and everything, Sony's marketing for Dreams has been absolute zero. There's been nothing about this at all. I haven't seen any adverts for it or anything like that. It comes out on Valentine's Day. You'd probably only know it comes out on Valentine's Day because Valentine's Day is a notable date, I guess. And if you were a big Dreams fan, you would know about that. But besides that, you wouldn't have known that Dreams comes out today on Valentine's Day. That, to me, is very weird. But I understand, because it's maybe a hard sell for Sony to try get people to dive into this, because it's not really a game. It's more of a tool. And I understand that completely. But holy shit, they've got a gold mine with this thing. And the sooner they realize it, the better. I could go into all sorts of detail about how the tools work and what kind of things you can make and how in depth you could get with a lot of things in this game, but that's really for you to kind of figure out yourself and what your imagination kind of holds and what you want to do in terms of creating. In terms of playing, the possibilities are endless. There is just endless possibilities for you to play as many games as possible, made by people around the world for technically completely free, no add-ons, no charge, no nothing. You buy the game, you get an endless supply of just people's creativity and what they can come up with. And some of the things I've seen so far are mind-blowing. I think Dreams is honestly for the type of person who just loves video games. And I know that's a bit of a cliche, but this is for everyone who wanted to create a video game. This is for everyone who had a dream or an idea that they wanted to put into a video game and wanted people to possibly play it, but they had no experience of how to do it or anything like that. And it's also for people who want to create things in a casual way. You know, I think there's also this side of things with game dev that it's an incredibly hard thing to do and no one tries to attempt it because it is just a very complex thing and it takes forever. But with Dreams, it kind of breaks down those barriers of allowing you to do this, again, from the comfort of your own home with a PlayStation 4 controller. I'm just so impressed with Dreams. Little Big Planet was one thing that was something that did impress me, but this is an absolute revolution or of what they tried to do with Little Big Planet. Like, it is a complete, let's try do something that no one thought we could do, and they absolutely did it. It is stunning. I can't wait to just see what people come up with when this game officially comes out today. For people who love to create or make games or anything like that, this is just essential. This is just something that you need to get your hands on and try for yourself and see how great it is and how easy it is to actually try and create these things. Yes, they take a long time because, you know, games take a long time to make, but the more you put into it, you know, the more you'll get out of this. It is literally a creation tool like no other. Nothing I've seen before. And I'm so, so impressed with it. So it's a bit difficult to rate this game because it's technically not a game, but it is a game. I'm rating this game based off the fact of its potential, what you can do with it when you get it, and just how much fun I've had with it since playing it for about a week or so. Potential is endless. You know, what may happen in 5 years, I don't know with Dreams. There could be some, like, I don't know, 6-hour games in there, in Dreams that you could play. I don't know. There could be fully blown open worlds that are really detailed that someone's been working on for years or something that blow AAA games out of the water. I really don't know. But I'm excited. And that's the main thing I want to highlight over Dreams. It's a exciting thing. It's an exciting product. I think it's one of the best things that's come out in a long time in terms of just potential. And it's definitely one of the games of the year. If it is a game of the year, then yeah, I wouldn't be sad with that, because even with a year with Cyberpunk coming out and Final Fantasy VII remakes and stuff, this thing is like none of those. It's completely unique and it's completely different. There's nothing else like it. And I absolutely love it, and I can't wait to see where it goes. So what score do I give to something that has endless possibilities? I mean, I can't give it any higher than this. I'm going to give Dreams a 10 out of 10. Dreams has everything you could possibly think of if you love video games. That's it. That's why it's a 10 out of 10 game. And I couldn't think of any way to say it better than that. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this review of Dreams. If this is your first time watching a review of mine, please subscribe to the channel for more reviews. I will be doing, obviously, more 2020 games when they come out. My next one is probably Doom, which is coming out in March. But I will be doing more in the future. Rest of the videos I'll be doing is mostly focused on things I missed in 2019 and maybe even before that as well.